Welcome students, today we are going to see the topic of wave packet, phase velocity and group velocity in quantum mechanics. We are familiar with the equation of a wave traveling in positive x-axis direction. That wave is given by y is equal to a sine of omega t minus kx. So this equation 1, it represents a wave traveling along positive x-axis. Here a is the amplitude of the wave, omega is the angular frequency and it is equal to twice pi f, where small f is the frequency of the wave. K is equal to twice pi upon lambda and it is called the wave vector. Now, the velocity with which each wave propagates in some medium is called the phase velocity, or it is the velocity with which the phase or the angle associated with each wave of particular frequency travels in a medium. We know in mathematics the trigonometric functions sine, cos, tan, etc. If we say sine theta, then theta is the angle. In the same way, here the term phase represents the angle associated with the wave and it is given by phase is equal to omega t minus kx. Thus, the velocity of a wave such that its phase or the angle remains constant with the time is called phase velocity and it is denoted by vp. So, if the phase remains constant, it means the quantity in the bracket omega t minus kx, this remains constant. If we differentiate this quantity with respect to time, then we get omega minus k dx upon dt is equal to 0, which implies that dx upon dt, this is a velocity, dx upon dt, it is represented by vp, that is the phase velocity. It comes out to be the ratio of omega upon k. Thus, phase velocity vp is equal to omega upon k. Now, if you substitute the values twice pi f for omega and twice pi upon lambda for k and solve this, you will get the phase velocity of a wave. It is equal to product of frequency and the wavelength. That is also equal to lambda upon the time period T, capital T. Just remember that frequency is nothing but 1 by T. Next we see the group velocity. Consider a beam of material particles, then each particle will have a wave associated with it. Now consider two such waves which slightly differ in the frequencies. One wave is having frequency omega and the other one will be having slightly different frequency omega plus d omega. If these waves are traveling in same direction, they will overlap to produce a wave packet. These are two different waves of slightly different frequencies. They travel in the same direction, then they produce a wave packet, which is given here. This is the wave packet. Now see here the same figure. Two different waves of slightly different frequencies, they produce a wave packet. The velocity with which a wave packet moves forward in the medium is called the group velocity, and it is denoted by Vg. And mathematically, Vg is equal to the difference. It is the ratio of difference in angular velocity to the difference in wave vector. So Vg is equal to omega 2 minus omega 1 divided by k2 minus k1. So this is equal to delta omega upon delta k. If there is a small and continuous variation, then the group velocity Vg is given by d omega upon dA. So what are these omega 1, omega 2? They are the angular frequency. K1 and K2 are the wave vectors associated with the two waves. So a beam of material particles like electron shows wave nature. Every material particle has a beam or a wave associated with it, and when these waves travel in a same direction, they superimpose with each other to produce a wave packet. So these are the two beams associated with two particles. They are traveling in the same direction. They overlap to produce a wave packet. This is the wave packet. Now, if the two waves interfere constructively, then the amplitude of the wave packet at that point is maximum, and at that point, the probability of finding the material particle is also maximum. Now, if the two waves interfere destructively at a point, then the amplitude of the wave packet at that point will be zero, and the probability of finding the particle at that particular point will be minimum or nearly zero. Thus, the wave packet represents the material particle and it moves with the group velocity Vg. So, this figure will make it more clear. This is a wave packet which is formed due to interference or due to overlapping of individual waves. These blue waves, they are individual waves. In this case, it is the green ones. Individual waves are moving with a velocity called phase velocity. If they travel in the same direction and overlap, they produce a wave packet. Now observe these two figures. In these two figures, at this particular point, the amplitude of the wave packet is maximum. Here the probability of finding the particle is maximum. And at what happens at this point? Here there is destructive overlapping, destructive interference of the wave. So amplitude is zero, and the probability of finding the particle at this particular edges where the amplitude is zero, the probability of finding the particle here is zero. It is maximum where the amplitude of wave packet is maximum. So next we see what is the relation between the phase velocity and group velocity. We know that the phase velocity is equal to omega upon k. So omega is equal to Vp into k. Differentiate this with respect to k. So we get d omega upon dk. This is equal to Vp plus k dvp upon dk. But from equation 4, Vg is equal to d omega upon dk. Substitute this in equation 5. So we get Vg is equal to d omega upon dk, that is equal to Vp plus k dvp upon d lambda into d lambda upon dk. I have introduced the term in the denominator and numerator. Which term? D lambda in the numerator and the denominator in this equation. But we know that k is a wave vector and has value k is equal to twice pi upon lambda. So lambda is equal to twice pi upon k, which gives me d lambda upon dk is equal to minus twice pi upon k square. Substitute this value in equation 6 in place of d lambda upon dk. I have substituted minus twice pi upon k square. So I get the group velocity Vg. This is equal to phase velocity minus twice pi upon k dvp upon d lambda. But k is equal to twice pi upon lambda. So using this relation, I can write twice pi upon k is equal to lambda. So finally I get equation 7, that is the group velocity Vg is equal to phase velocity minus lambda dvp upon d lambda. And equation 7 use the relationship between the phase velocity Vp and the group velocity Vg. Now let's see some cases related to this equation. If the wave packet is traveling in a non-dispersive medium. What is a non-dispersive medium? It is a medium where the wave properties do not depend upon the material. In a non-dispersive medium, the wave properties are same in every direction. It does not depend upon the material. So, this quantity dvp upon d lambda becomes equal to 0. And therefore, equation 7 reduces to Vg is equal to Vp. So, what does this mean? For dispersive medium, the group velocity is equal to the phase velocity. And what is the example of this? The speed of light or electromagnetic radiation in vacuum. We all know it is a constant quantity. So, speed of light in vacuum, this is an example of group velocity is equal to phase velocity. Second case, for dispersive medium, exactly opposite to the non-dispersive medium, the dispersive medium are such that the wave properties, they depend upon the material and they are different in different directions. Means in all the direction, the wave properties will not remain same. For such a medium, dvp upon d lambda is not equal to 0. So, it means either it can be positive or it can be negative. So, two cases arise. If we take the first case, if dvp upon d lambda is positive, then observe this relation. If dvp upon d lambda is positive, means you are subtracting something from vp. So, in that case, Vg becomes less than Vp. For a dispersive medium, the group velocity is less than phase velocity if dvp upon d lambda is positive. What is the example of this particular case? The speed of electromagnetic wave in dielectric medium. For electromagnetic wave in dielectric medium, the group velocity Vg is always less than the phase velocity Vp. Another case, if dvp upon d lambda is negative, then observe this equation. This quantity gets added to Vp. So, Vg is equal to Vp plus something. So, this means the group velocity is greater than phase velocity in this case. And example is speed of electromagnetic wave in conducting medium. Conducting mediums means metals. Now we have seen that the particles are represented by wave packet. And wave packet moves with a velocity Vg. Now, is there a relation between the velocity of a particle and velocity of a wave packet? Let us see this. What is our aim? To show that group velocity is equal to the particle velocity. In other words, we have to show or we are going to see if group velocity with which the wave packet moves is equal to the particle velocity or the velocity with which the particle moves. Now consider a beam of particle where the particles are moving with velocity v. Then the de Broglie wavelength associated with the particle is given by lambda is equal to h upon v. So make rearrangement, we get p is equal to h upon lambda, multiply and divide by twice k, then we get p is equal to h cross into k. How? H upon twice pi means h cross and twice pi upon lambda means k. So I get p is equal to h cross k. So dp is equal to h cross into dk, which gives me dk is equal to dp upon h cross. Now, for a wave of frequency nu, if the wave is having frequency nu, its energy is given by E is equal to h nu. So, if I multiply and divide by twice pi here, then I get h upon twice pi, which is h cross, and twice pi into frequency, that is angular frequency omega. So, I get E is equal to h cross into omega. If I differentiate it, I get dE is equal to h cross d omega. So d omega is equal to d upon h cross. Now what was our relation for group velocity? Group velocity is equal to d omega upon dk. So I get by using equation 9 and 11, I get group velocity vg is equal to dE upon dp. That is our equation 12. Now the electrons or the particles, if they are moving with a speed comparable to the speed of light, they are relativistic particles, and in that case the energy of that particle is given by E square is equal to P square C square plus M0 square C raised to the power 4. Since the rest mass M0, if you take electron, it is very small. The rest mass of these particles moving with relativistic speed is very small. In that case, the second term becomes very small. See, in case of electron, it is 9.1 10 raised to the power minus 31 kg. If you square it, it will be 10 raised to the power minus 62. So, this second quantity becomes very small. It can be neglected. And so, we get E square is equal to P square C square. Differentiate this equation, so we get twice E dE is equal to twice P C square into dP. If I rearrange the terms, I get dE upon dP is equal to P C square upon E. That is our equation 15. Now by Einstein's mass energy relation, E is equal to mc square, and we know that momentum is equal to mass into velocity for the particle. So if you put this in this equation, substitute, instead of P you will write M into V, instead of E you can write MC square. If you substitute this, finally you get dE upon dP. This is equal to V. Now what was our equation 12? Group velocity is equal to dE upon dP. Equation 16 was dE upon dP is equal to V, the velocity of the particle. So finally we can conclude that the group velocity is equal to the particle velocity V. So what is our conclusion from equation 17? We can see that the group velocity Vg with which the wave packet moves, it is equal to the velocity v with which the particle moves. Thus, the group velocity of the wave packet associated with the particles is equal to the velocity v or the particle velocity v. That's all about the wave packet, the phase velocity and group velocity. Have a nice day.